How do you really think the youth of today is different from the youth probably of your era?
Thanks. It's drastically different, so that's why Srundhudaya was tremendously challenging for me. I grew up in a totally uninformed zone. We didn't have any of this. You know, this whole generation of connectivity, like we spoke, Twitter or Facebook or any of these platforms to communicate and connect. We had none of that. We had a more quiet upbringing, I think, more silent. It has, as I said, its pros and cons. I think a lot of us were more, I think we're less informed, but more in touch with ourselves. And I think that really made us the people we are. I find today's generation brilliant. Almost, they're all geniuses. They're so informed. They're full of zest and energy. But I don't think they're in touch with themselves. Most of them are so scattered because there's so much to do that they don't really touch base with their inner core. And that's the one advantage all of us who are in their 40s today will definitely say, that we have a sense of self-evolution that the generation today does not have, unfortunately. But what they have, we never did. They're so much more confident. They're so much more out there. You put them on a platform, you put them on a stage, you put them anywhere. I'm seeing that with the three of them. There's a vulnerability about them because it's a first-time experience, but yet the sense of confidence is very enviable. I mean, I know that when I was their age, actually, I had made kuch kuch hota, so I can't. I was trying to kind of be humble, but it didn't work there. Okay, so I'm saying that when I was Alia's age, definitely, I was all over the place in my head. And I see a lot of youngsters that are so completely connected and out there that it's almost amazing to see. We were, like, for the lack of a better word, I think, totally not cool in that respect. You know, we were so uncool. At least I was. I still remember hearing thinking the Walkman is the biggest invention of India, you know. Or when the mobile phone came out, I still remember my feeling that I had a phone that was ringing in my hand when I was down the hill of my building. I couldn't believe that. The pleasure of, I went through the phase of discovering there was something called color on television. I still remember watching the Wimbledon, and I have no interest in tennis, only to see the lawn look green on my TV. So I remember that I've been through these pleasures. You know, so today when everything is like a click away and everything is on your phone and, you know, like you're talking ASL, so we're saying, imagine carrying an entire life on a phone. That to me was incomprehensible. But that's the reality of today, and things are, I'm eventually wondering where technology is going to go. I think we'll just be sitting in one place and just seeing the whole world. I eventually feel that maybe I won't live to see that, but yeah, who knows. Currently, I'm an old soul, so no matter, even at 20 I was old. At 40 it's just a matter of age. To project student life is a result of my many observations. That's the one thing I think I always have been excelling within, is observing, and that's what I've done. Luckily for me, I'm surrounded by a lot of young energy in my office, and I encourage it. Dharma Productions is one of the coolest offices in Mumbai, I have to say. Full of young people, full of young ideas, ideologies, and that's what has nurtured my thought process. And that's the one thing I will always encourage. I surround myself by younger people, so I feel alive. You know, normally children do that to you, and I don't have that. Normally children make you feel more connected. Like if I had a son or daughter, I would know what's happening in the hip-hop zone, or, you know, in the zone of music. Like I hear Alia, Varun and Sid listening to songs, I can't understand. But at least I know that there's that kind of music. Like for the first time when Bosco and Caesar came to me and said, hey, this is dubstep. And I was like, right. And then I went and Googled and said, what the hell is dubstep? Like, I didn't know. I knew breakdance. But I didn't know breakdance has gone into five different branches after that. So it's just the process. And I feel every filmmaker who's my age, I should actually always touch base with the youth, because that's the audience we are catering to. So if we talk commerce and commercial, then I have to make sure that I'm always connected. Otherwise, there's no point in being in a constantly adaptive industry.
Karan Johar ka filmmaking style hai, aur jo aapke पिताजी का फिल्म मेकिंग स्टाइल है भट्ट साहब का, उसके बीच में आप किससे ज्यादा आइडेंटिफाई करती हैं, खुद को रिलेट कर पाती हैं?
जो पिक्चर मेरे फादर बना चुके हैं, जिसलिए जखम, अर्थ, सारांश, वो बहुत ही इंटेंस फिल्म्स है, आई वुड से, और बहुत ही बेहतरीन पिक्चर है. कारण जैसे कि हम सब जानते हैं, ही इज वेरी यूथ ओरिएंटेड, ग्लॉसी, फन. तो आई कांट
मेरी फ्रिवलेस है मूवीज,
आई कांट चूज़ between my teacher and my father. So I would say I love both of them.
Good comeback.
But क्या जिस तरह भट्ट साहब फिल्म में हीरोइंस को दिखाते हैं क्या आप अपने पापा की फिल्म में उस तरह से पोर्ट्रेट होना चाहेंगे?
आप किस फिल्म के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं?
चाहे राज 3 हो, मर्डर हो,
राज 8 में मैं काम करना चाहूंगी जी. राज 8 जब रिलीज होगी तो आप मुझे देखोगे वापस.
और वरुण आप आपका क्या ख्याल है?
मैं भी राज 8 में हूँ. यू मीन फॉर माय डैड?
जी
आई थिंक सी मैंने एक ही पिक्चर किया अभी, उसका नाम है स्टूडेंट ऑफ द ईयर. और मैं जो किरदार निभा रहा हूँ रोहन नंदा का, उसमें वो मेरे एज ग्रुप के आमने सामने है, तो मैं ऑब्वियसली इस पिक्चर से ज़्यादा आइडेंटिफाई करता हूँ कि मेरे एज ग्रुप के सामने. सो ऑब्वियसली बीइंग माय फर्स्ट एक्सपीरियंस आई गेस आई आइडेंटिफाई मोर विद करण सिनेमा एट द मोमेंट.
बहुत अच्छे करण, आपने बहुत अच्छे से सबको पढ़ाया हुआ है.
यहाँ आने से पहले एक घंटे का सेशन हुआ था उनके साथ, बाकायदा ट्रेन करके आए.